हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज क्लास 10th, सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश एंड चैप्टर 7th, द नेकलेस. दिस वी स्टार्टेड यस्टरडे एंड दिस इज माय लेक्चर 2. फर्स्ट लेक्चर इज ऑलरेडी डिलीवर्ड. Topics to be covered today. These are the topics that today we are going to cover in this lecture. First is chapter highlights. First of all, we shall discuss chapter highlights, and after that, word meaning of this chapter, the necklace, and at last, we shall discuss homework solution of lecture 1 of this chapter, the necklace. So let us start with chapter highlights. So let us begin with chapter highlights. Already we have read about the writer of this chapter. We have read the introduction and overview of this chapter, the necklace. So today, first of all, we shall read chapter highlights. So let us start. So let us start with Matilda. As you know that she is the main character of this chapter, the necklace. She is an ordinary woman. She is unhappy with her monotonous, simple life, with her boring life. She was unhappy. She always dreams of grandeur all the time. Means she wants to live a life of luxury all the time. But actually, she was very poor. Due to error of destiny, she was born into a family of clerks. But Mr. Loisel, Matilda's husband, is satisfied with what he has. He never complains about his condition. He is also happy being a clerk. He was a petty clerk, still was very happy. Loisels get invited to a ball at the Minister of Public Instruction's place. Means one day Mr. Loisel got an invitation card from a minister, but Matilda was not delighted at all. Loisel thinks that his wife would be very happy. Mr. Loisel thought that she would be very happy to know about the invitation to the ball. So he thought that she would be very happy to know this, but Matilda is displeased and she was not happy and she refused to go as she doesn't have a beautiful dress to wear to the ball. She didn't have a dress to wear in that party. So her husband offers to buy her a dress for 400 francs. These 400 francs were collected by Mr. Loisel because he wanted to buy a gun. But still, he gave that money to Matilda for buying a beautiful dress. Now, after getting money, Matilda buys a good dress but is still unhappy. Still, she was not happy as she has no jewel to compliment the beautiful dress. She didn't have any ornament to wear with that beautiful dress. So her husband suggests her to borrow jewels from her friend, Ma'am Forestier. Ma'am Forestier was very rich. So Ma'am Forestier lends Matilda a diamond necklace. Ma'am Forestier showed Matilda Loisel different jewels, but Matilda selected a beautiful diamond necklace. So she borrowed a beautiful diamond necklace from her friend Ma'am Forestier. Now the day of ball arrived and she attended the party. Matilda becomes a celebrity at the ball party as everyone admires her beauty because she was looking very elegant and gracious. Unfortunately, the couple discovers the necklace is lost as they reach home. Means when they reached home, they found that necklace was lost. Mr. Loisel contacts the police, cab offices, advertises to award the finder of the necklace, but to no avail, all in vain, they did not find the necklace. So at last they decide to buy a new necklace to replace it because there was no other option in front of them. So here we have read that Matilda Loisel enjoyed the party and danced with enthusiasm as she was looking very beautiful. All the men looked at her and they also wanted to have her company. But after reaching her home, when she removed the wraps from her shoulders before the glass, she found that there was no necklace around her neck. So she cried suddenly. Now they tried to find it out everywhere. Mr. Loisel went to the police, cab offices, and also gave an advertisement in the newspapers. But there was no clue of necklace. So at the end of the day, they became hopeless. So now they decided to buy a new diamond necklace to replace it. So Mr. Loisel collects 18,000 francs and they borrow 18,000 more to pay for the new necklace. Means they bought a new diamond necklace in 36,000 francs. So the couple spend 10 years to pay back the debt. Working day and night, they worked day and night, they struggled a lot and suffering from dire poverty. 10 years of poverty and misery render them old and weary. So for buying a new necklace, they had to borrow 18,000 francs and now they knew the horrible life of necessity. To pay this debt, they sent away the maid, they changed their lodgings and rented some rooms in an attic, and Matilda also washed the dishes, clothes and dish clothes, etc. So Mr. Loisel also worked in evenings, day and night, and now Matilda was too old because 10 years of poverty and misery made them old and tired. Now, she had become a strong and hard woman. After 10 years, Matilda meets Ma'am Forestier one day and narrates the story of the necklace that she replaced with a new one. Ma'am Forestier informs her the necklace was worth just 500 francs. Means the lost necklace worth was not more than 500 francs. So one Sunday she met Ma'am Forestier when she was walking. So now Matilda told the entire story of her miserable condition to Ma'am Forestier, and the necklace was only responsible for this. So at this, Ma'am Forestier got surprised and she said that it was the false necklace. Its worth was not more than 500 francs. So from this chapter, we actually learn a lesson that we should be satisfied with our life. We should be contented with our life. We should have satisfaction with whatever we have. Now, let us read word meaning of this chapter. First word is petty. It means of lesser rank or importance. Then next is incessantly. It means continuously. Next is tureen. Its meaning is a deep bowl with a cover used for serving soup. Now next words. Next is despair. It means a complete loss of hope. Next is elated. Elated means to be extremely joyful. Now next words. Now next word, it is spitefully. It means hurtfully. Next word, it is dismay. Its meaning is a feeling of unhappiness and disappointment. Next word is usurer. It means money lender. Now next words. Attic. It means a space or room inside the roof, inside the roof of a building. Next is crude. It means very simple. Next is sou. It is a French coin of low value. Now your homework. Homework is to read the chapter thoroughly and write down all the question and answers and word meaning as well that we have done today in your English notebook. So beta, you all are supposed to read the chapter thoroughly. Reading is must, and write down all the question answers in your fair notebook, and word meaning which we have discussed today, that also you have to write. I hope you have understood this chapter. So write down all the question answers and send at my email address. This is class 10th, subject English. This is homework solution of lecture 1 of chapter 7, the necklace. So let us discuss the question answers which were given to you. Question 1. It was, what kind of a person is Ma'am Loisel, means Matilda, and why is she always unhappy? Matilda always remained unhappy. What was the reason? So the answer is, Ma'am Loisel is a very unhappy and unsatisfied person. She is not happy. Why? Because she was not satisfied. She is not happy with her married life. She wants to get married with a rich person, but she got married with a petty clerk. She is not happy with her married life, her house, or for that matter, anything in her life. So Ma'am Loisel was a very pretty young lady. She was born in a family of clerks. She felt that she was born for all the luxuries, but unluckily she had to live a simple and economical life. She completely disliked her circumstances, so this made her angry and unhappy. Matilda always keeps on dreaming about how her life would be. Actually, she thought that she was born for all delicacies. So she keeps on dreaming about how her life would have been if she were born in a rich house, married in a rich house, and had lots of money to buy things, buy all those luxurious things that she wanted. She is a greedy woman. She wants to have all luxurious things, and she always keeps on thinking of having more and more. She always wanted to have more and more things. That's why she always remained unhappy. Actually, she wanted all those things that she didn't have. This is the reason of her unhappiness. Now, second question, it is, what kind of a person is her husband, Mr. Loisel? Her husband is a very caring and a loving man. He is not greedy, as he always stays happy with whatever he has. He was satisfied with her life. He appreciates the little things that life has given him and doesn't want to see his wife unhappy, for which he sacrifices his own needs. Her husband was actually a clerk in the office of the Board of Education, and he was satisfied with his life. He was also a very loving husband. He always tries his best to please Matilda. Even he gave 400 francs to buy a beautiful dress to Ma'am Loisel. Otherwise, he had saved that money to buy a gun. Now, next question. Question 3. It is, what fresh problem now disturbs Ma'am Loisel? So the answer is, Ma'am Loisel's husband agrees to buy her a dress worth 400 francs and sacrifices his own requirement of buying a gun. But Ma'am Loisel Being a greedy woman starts acting strangely and demands jewelry to wear, or else she will not go to the party. Now the fresh problem was of jewelry. Ma'am Loisel didn't have any ornament to wear with that beautiful dress. So now still she was unhappy after buying the dress. Now fourth question, it is, how is the problem solved? Means how is the problem of jewelry solved? For this, what did she do? When she doesn't agree to wear natural flowers to the party. Actually, Mr. Loisel suggested her to wear some natural flowers, but she denied. Her husband suggests her to approach her rich friend, ma'am Forestier, who is a rich lady. She was very rich lady, so she could lend her jewelry to wear at the ball or at the party. So first of all, she was advised to wear some natural flowers instead of any jewelry, but she refused. Then Mr. Loisel suggested her to go to Ma'am Forestier to borrow jewelry. Now question fifth, what do Mr. and Ma'am Loisel do next? Means what did they do when they came to know that they had lost the necklace? So Mr. and Ma'am Loisel make a lot of efforts after they realize that they have lost the necklace. They try to remember the cab number so that they can check there. Mr. Loisel goes to the tracks where she could have dropped it, where she could have dropped that necklace. He reports at the police station and cab offices. He also gives an advertisement in the newspapers, even offering a reward for the finder, saying that the person who returns this necklace will be rewarded. But nothing works. Means they were unable to find the necklace. So they finally decide to replace the necklace with a new one by buying a necklace. So they did the same. They bought a similar necklace to replace that one that they have lost. So they finally decide to replace the necklace by buying a necklace similar to the one they have lost. Now, question number sixth. It is, how do they replace the necklace? Means, how do Mr. and Ma'am Loisel replace the necklace? How did they manage? So, the answer is, they buy a necklace from a shop for 36,000 francs. They themselves have only 18,000 francs, which were left by Loisel's father. So rest of the money was borrowed by them. So they borrow the rest of the money at a very high rate of interest by making up false stories and taking loans from a lot of lenders, from a lot of money lenders. So they had to spend 10 years to pay that debt. So Loisel asked Matilda to write a letter to Ma'am Forestier explaining that she had broken the clasp of the necklace. This was only an excuse, but later on they decided to replace the necklace. So they bought a similar necklace for 36,000 francs. Loisel had 18,000 francs which his father had left him. He borrowed the rest from various sources. So finally he bought the necklace and gave it to Matilda for her to take it back to Ma'am Forestier. Thank you.